More cornflakes, Mr. Hancock.
Yes, please.
I'll have to open a new packet.
No, I want to open it. There. Isn't it annoying? Doesn't it make you sick? I've got him.
You've got what?
This little plastic soldier, I've got him. Why can't you buy packets of the ones I haven't got?
How do I know what's inside them?
Well, it tells you on the front, free all this month, plastic guardsman. Make your own guards band up. Look at this, a trombone player, I've got him. I've got him 6 times. Daft grin on his face, look at him, I've a good mind to break him.
I haven't got him, Tub.
Well, what have you got to change?
I've got a spare drummer.
I've got him. The only one I'm missing is the trumpet player. Miss Pugh, go down and buy another packet of cornflakes with a trumpet player inside.
Oh, really? I bought 43 packets last month just to find the flute player. They're all open, a sheer waste. They'll never get eaten.
Yes, they will. The next party we have, put some salt on them and tell everybody they're crisps. I'll get rid of them. I must complete my band. It's all your fault we've had to buy so many packets. You could easily poke your finger under the lid and see what they've got inside.
Strangely enough, when I buy a packet of cornflakes, I buy it for the cornflakes.
Oh, well, that's a typical woman's attitude, isn't it? I mean to say. I mean, no imagination. It's the thrill of the hunt. Getting your set together, looking them on the mantelpiece there, marching along there. Oh, marvellous. What a stirring sight. A complete band. Minus a trumpet player. I've been waiting 3 weeks for that trumpet player. Breakfast is making me a nervous wreck, I don't mind telling you. I come down here every morning full of open anticipation, with me fingers trembling as I open a fresh packet. And what happens? Trombone players all over the place. It's very soul-destroying.
Let me have your trombone player.
No.
I've only got a drummer.
That is your fault. You've been eating cornflakes as long as I have.
Yeah, but you always open them. You whip it before I get a chance.
You should get up in the morning. You're not having my trombone player.
Oh, shut up. I don't know what you're fighting about. Next week, they'll probably finish with the guardsmen and start an entirely different set.
Oh, will they? Miss Pugh, take a letter to the makers. Dear sir, I hereby warn you that if you discontinue putting guardsmen in your cornflakes before I've got my set, I shall in future eat porridge. Yours sincerely, A. Hancock, age 7½. That'll frighten them. I'm ready for my bacon and peace pudding now, Miss Pugh. If there's any left. Look at her plate piled up there. You can't see her, just her arms coming round the sides. Are you there?
Of course I am.
Well, come on then, shovel it out, whack some on the plate. 2 rashers and a dollop. That's enough. Go on, get back behind your breakfast. I'd rather look at that than you. Haven't you finished with that paper yet, Kerr?
No, wait a minute. I haven't read it all yet.
I'm not waiting for you to read it. By the time you've stumbled through it, it'll be yesterday's. Now, give it to me. Hello, hello. They're at it again. You can't trust them, can you? Oh, this man does talk some rubbish. Hello, I see he's got 3 years. I knew he was guilty when I saw his photo last week. Had a moustache, that was enough for me. Butter's going up in China. Hey, it was snowing yesterday in the north of Scotland. It was lovely down here, wasn't it? Man denies weekend in caravan. Oh, she's nice. 17-year-old model from Gateshead. Record crop of rice in Tibet this year. Vicar punches driving instructor. She doesn't look 17, does she? Oh, look at this kitten sitting in the Wellington boot. Isn't that lovely? She's got a nice figure, hasn't she? Aye, aye, I see Mr. X has been had up again. He's in every week. He'll overdo it one day. 17 years old, eh? Oh, there's a good film south of the river this week. I was a teenage rock and roll vampire and kissed the blood off my washboard. Marvellous. I have to get there early before the schools come out. I'd like to bet she's nearly 18.
Your peas pudding and bacon's getting cold.
Do you mind?
If you don't want
You're not having it. Look at her plate, Bill. Scraped half the willow pattern off she has. Only half the bridge and one leg of a Chinaman left. Now shut up and let me read my paper in peace. If she's 17, I'm a Dutchman. I see there's another election coming in East Cheam.
Oh, what happened to that nice man who was in before?
He's resigned, and I'm not surprised. A right mess up he made of it.
He was a very sincere man.
Sincere? He was in Parliament 3 years and not a sound out of him. He woke up once and yelled out, resign. And even then he was had up on the carpet.
Why?
It was one of his own side speaking. Just as well he's out of it. They're all the same, these politicians. They're either flying out somewhere or flying back or ringing bells or having eggs chucked at them. I've no time for them.
I've been thinking, if you break the end off the trombone, it'll look like a trumpet. Pardon? The trombone man. If you chop his trombone
off... I'll chop your trombone off if you don't... We're discussing politics.
Yeah. Okay. Well, it was just a thought. I was just looking at it while it was standing there, and I thought to myself, if you broke the end off the trombone, it'd look just like a trumpet, and then you wouldn't have to buy any more cornflakes because you got the trumpet player, even if it is a trombone with the end broken off, which you wouldn't notice unless you looked close and saw where it was broken, if you were a musician.
Vote for Kerr, independent fool. He'd be a cert. He explains things so beautifully. Have the opposition confused after three lines.
Who's standing this time?
Oh, the usual rubbish. Sir Reginald Featherstone Hall, Conservative, and Arnold Biggs, Labour. Or is it the other way around? You can't tell these days.
Which one's the best looking?
What does it matter what they look like? Honestly, if women had their way, there'd be 612 Rudolph Valentinos up in the House of Commons. Show a bit of responsibility, woman. When I think of what Mrs. Pankhurst and her mob went through to get the likes of you the vote, she must shudder when she sees the horrors you vote for. All teeth and hair oil.
Not just their looks. I search in their faces for honesty and integrity.
Honesty and integrity. What about the spiv you put in on the council? When they put the chain of office round him, his shoulder pads fell down each side. You've always been a fool for a pretty face.
Tub, have I got a vote?
I shouldn't think so. Peers, clergymen and idiots don't get a vote over there.
Take no notice of him. Of course you've got a vote. Who are you going to vote for, Mr. Hancock?
Neither of them. I don't hold with politics. I shall show my contempt by going down to the polling booth, taking my form, crossing both their names out and writing, get knotted in. Nothing but the utmost dislike for politicians.
Morning, all.
Hello, Sid. Come in. You're around a bit early this morning, aren't you?
Just going home. Popped in for a bit of breakfast. What do you got?
What a liberty. Halfway house, this. Hancock's pulling for weary travellers. They wander in here for a cup of tea and a change of clothing. Had a bloke in yesterday for a hot dog. I'd never even seen him before. You come in here at 7:30 in the morning and ask for breakfast. I suppose you've been out all night again.
Yep.
What have you been doing?
Working. Mind if I put my sack down? Now then, what you got? I'm starving.
What's in that sack?
Nothing. A few odds and ends, that's all.
Come on, show me. Odds and ends. 300 weight of assorted lead here. Sawn off rainwater pipes. A few curly bits from under somebody's sink. And all these bits of gas pipe. There won't be a lamp in the high street working tonight.
I found it all lying on a waste dump down the road.
No, you didn't. You've been creeping around Cheam all night with a hacksaw. Every night it's the same. Lead one week, brass the next week, copper the next week. This town will be in bits if you don't turn it in.
No, it won't. They're just odd bits I see sticking out of walls. I just trim them down a bit.
You can't go around chopping bits of rainwater pipes off. It's not like pruning trees.
Are you going to give me any breakfast or not? I can pay for it. Here, 2 foot of waste pipe.
Get that off my table.
That's worth seven and a tenner, that bit.
I don't care how much it's worth. Get it off the table. You come in here trying to barter with your night's pickings. 2 foot of pipe for some cornflakes and peas pudding, whatever next. It's worth two curly bits and a section of gutter in any time, that is.
You drive a hard bargain. Here.
That's better. Miss Pugh, give him some peas pudding.
What about the cornflakes?
Ah, all right.
Yeah. Where's the little plastic guardsman?
They've all gone.
Ah, blimey, I only need a trumpet player.
So do I. You're the third one I know who only wants a trumpet player. Do you think they're still making them?
Yes, I know a bloke in Epsom who's got 6 trumpet players. He's looking for the trombone player.
Stone me, and I've got a box full of trombone players. Just shows you the distribution's all wrong. The sales manager, he doesn't know his job. They should have a certain number of each sent to one area.
Of course they should.
I didn't have this trouble with me fag cards. Complete set of footballers within the fortnight.
Well, that's the way it goes. Anything in the papers?
No. Oh, no, there's a nice bird from Gateshead on page 2. 17, it says.
Ooh. Let's have a look at that. Oh, yeah. She never 17.
Yeah, that's what I said. Didn't I say that? Didn't I say she wasn't 17?
Yeah, I see the price of butter's gone up in China.
Yeah, well, I could see that coming. There's so many of them, that's the trouble. Half a pound goes nowhere.
Yeah. He got 3 years, then.
Yeah, well, it stood out a mile. He had a moustache, you know.
Yeah. I reckon this bird's nearer 21, you know.
As old as that?
Yeah.
Well, I said 18.
Could be. Why don't they eat margarine?
Who?
In China.
Well, perhaps they don't like margarine in China.
Ah, yes, I expect that's what it is.
Sid?
Yeah?
Why don't you chop the end off one of your trombone players so that it'd look like a trumpet player? You wouldn't be able to tell the difference unless you looked at it closely.
Shut up.
Well, I just thought that maybe if he didn't have a trumpet
player... We know what you thought.
Just occurred to me that he could...
We know.
Well, you know...
Oh, it's a good cartoon today, isn't it?
What, the political one?
Yes.
Oh, very good. They always are. He's very good, that bloke.
Yeah, always gets straight to the point, doesn't he?
Yes, yes, he does. He hits the nail right on the head. That needed saying, that did.
Yeah, they ought to show that to every politician in the house.
Of course they should. Very satirical. Brings it right home, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I wonder what he's getting at.
I haven't the faintest idea. Very good drawing, though, isn't it? They got a nerve trying to kid us, that bird 17.
Could have been a printer's error.
That's true, it does happen. Now, listen, they called me Tommy Hitchcock the other week.
No.
Yes. I wrote to them and they put in an apology. They've got it in, look, just there.
Yeah. We apologise for any embarrassment caused last week when we wrote about Mr. Tommy Hitchcock. We were, of course, referring to that celebrated comedian, Mr. Terry Hancock.
Well, it's near enough. You can't keep writing, can you?
Hello? They're holding a by-election round here. I didn't know that.
Yes, yes, the last one applied for the Chiltern Hundreds.
Well, I see. Well, if he gets it, I think the others ought to get a raise as well.
Well, so do I. After all, fair's fair.
No, no, that's not it. That's not it at all. The Chiltern Hundreds is a position created by the government, which MPs have to apply for when they want to give up their seats on account of that they're not allowed to just resign.
What do you know about it?
Yeah, why don't you mind your own business?
You buffoon. You come over here, you don't know what you're talking about, trying to tell us how our parliamentary system works. My word. The Chiltern Hundreds is an ancient custom. They apply for it when they want promotion. They get £100, a new suit and a badge allowing them to use the House of Lords canteen without being accompanied by Black Rod. I think you'll find that's right.
Well, who are you voting for, then?
Neither of them. I want nothing to do with politics at any price. What do they do for the common man? You may well ask. My cat got stuck up a tree last month. I wrote to my MP, and what did he do? Nothing. He didn't even come down. The cat is still up there. I have to send a whiting up on a pulley every lunchtime. All out for number one. Well, they're not getting my vote anymore. I'm withholding it. I'm going to be one of the don't-knows in future. Miss Pugh, there's somebody at the door.
Well?
Well, go and open it, then.
You've got legs, haven't you?
Yes, and you'll feel one if you don't go and open it.
They'll just have to wait. I'm finishing my pudding, the too-good-to-hurry pudding.
Go on, it might be important. It might be the grocer with the week's food. Look at that, she's gone. Up out of that chair like a Vanguard rocket.
Yes?
Good morning. Are you Mrs. Hancock?
You want a punch on the nose.
No offense.
I'm his secretary, and that's bad enough. What can I do for you?
Do you think I might speak to Mr. Hancock?
Won't you come in? That's him over there, the fat one in the red nightshirt.
Good morning, Mr. Hancock.
I'm sorry, Miss, there's no breakfast left.
Thank you, but I had breakfast. I don't know whether you're aware of it, but there's a by-election being held in this borough shortly.
Yes, we've just been talking about it.
Oh, good. Then you no doubt know that it's a straight fight between Conservative and the Socialist.
No. It says here Tory and Labour.
Yes, Well, that is the same thing.
Oh, they're cunning, hiding under another banner, you see. You can't trust them. They're after the floating voter.
Well, you don't support either of them, I take it?
I do not.
Capital. I'm from the East Cheam Independents. I'll come straight to the point. Will you be the independent candidate for East Cheam?
Me?
Yes.
But I don't know anything about politics.
It doesn't matter. You've been on television, haven't you?
Yes.
Well, good. That's all we demand of any candidate.
But I don't know anything about you. Shouldn't I know something about your policy?
Oh, no. It doesn't matter. Your program was quite popular, wasn't it?
Well, not bad. Here and there it had flashes, I must say.
Well, yes, there you are. That's all necessary.
Why pick on me?
Well, you're the only television personality living right here. We couldn't poach from any other boroughs. They're all being earmarked for the general election. You leave it all to us. You just sit in the meetings. The agent will answer all the questions. You can just nod a few times, sign a few autographs. That's all we require from you. We'll bill you as Tony Hancock, star of stage, screen, and independent party.
But I'm not independent. I mean, I'm not anything.
Ah, mere triviala. Don't you realize what it would mean to be an MP?
Yes, I'd have to go up and get my own cat down.
Apart from that, you could be one of the country's leaders. You might even become prime minister.
That'd be good. I could step out of aeroplanes waving me at, couldn't I?
Well, exactly. And go straight through the customs.
Take it, boy. Pay may not be so hot, but think of all those watches we could get through.
All right, I'll do it.
Good man. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'll pop back to HQ and prepare the campaign. Thank you, but... Why, say? A cornflake packet?
Yes.
You don't happen to have...
No, only trombone players.
Oh, bother. I only need a trumpet player. Never mind, keep in touch. Goodbye now.
Well, what do you think of that, eh? Me, an MP.
You're not in yet, big head.
Just a formality. I'll carry the saloon bar at the Hand and Racket for a start. They'll sell their soul for a pint of mild and bitter.
I think it's marvellous, son. We'll clean up.
Oh, here we are again. And what do you expect to get out of it?
I hear there's a fortune of lead on the House of Commons roof.
You will do no roof lifting while I'm in the house.
Well, all right, then. Perhaps you'll get me into the cabinet somehow. Chancellor of the Exchequer, charge of the loot. How about Home Secretary's? A couple of boys I want to get out of jail.
Sid, being an MP means having a lot of responsibility towards one's country.
Oh, dear, he's gone all patriotic now.
Forgetting his friends already. They're all the same. Power mad. Well, I'm not voting for you.
I don't care. There's enough people like my television programme who'll elect me. I shall put the issue before the electors purely and simply. Nay, bluntly. Vote for me or I won't go on television again. I think I shall go and change into my frock coat. I feel quite important. This is a far, far better thing I do now than I have ever done. Rembrandt. Thank you. Voters of East Cheam, in asking you, send me to Westminster. I have no need to remind you of my record.
5 years of Hancock's half hour on radio and 2 years on television. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you. One singer, one song, if you don't mind. Thank you. And what may have my two opponents got to match that record? 20 years as a trade unionist. 25 years on the council. Service in the diplomatic corps. Between them, 43 years in politics. All very nice. But has one of them ever been before the television cameras? No. Therefore, vote for Hancock, the viewer's choice. Are there any questions? Any questions you would like to know about my policy? Any points that are of vital interest to the nation?
Yes.
Over there, yes, sir.
When's Robin Hood coming back again?
Vote for me and I shall introduce a private member's bill to ensure we have Robin Hood every week of the year. Next question, please.
Does the continual watching of television affect the eyes?
Only if it's switched on. Next.
What do you intend to do about England entering the European common market, thus bringing about a more sound economic structure in Europe without endangering our interest in Commonwealth trade and imperial preferences?
Come, sir, this is no time for frivolous questions.
Oi!
Yes, sir.
How big's Diana Dawes?
A very good question, sir. How big is the prospective candidate for Leamington? I'm afraid, sir, these are official party figures which cannot be released until after the general election.
For you, Mr. Hancock. I haven't opened it.
Thank you, Miss Pugh. The swordfish letter opener, please. Cass. Another trombone player, I guess. When I get in, I'll nationalise that lot. I'll be Minister of Cornflakes. I'll get that set somehow. I'll have them sent out with nothing but trumpet players in.
Well, it's polling day today. What do you reckon your chances?
Oh, I shall landslide. I've got the House of Commons badge on the front of my bike already.
What do you think the poll's going to be like?
Well, we're expecting 100% turnout. I'm providing transport for the old people who can't get down there. Taking them down to my crossbar. Will you do some knocking up for me, Sid?
Certainly.
If there's no answer, you know what to do.
Yeah, nip inside and break open a gas meter.
You don't. You poke a pamphlet through the door.
You want me to do anything to the other candidates for you?
What sort of things?
Well, lay them up or something. Still got a bit of lead pipe I haven't flogged.
Sidney, this is a democratic election. You can't go around and laying people up. I careth not for what they say, but I will defend with my life their right to say it. Beethoven.
All right, then. Perhaps I can be of some help down at Town Hall tonight while the boys are counting the votes.
What have you got in mind?
Well, I thought perhaps fuse the lights in the middle and whip their bundles.
No, Sidney, we shan't be needing any of those methods. I have complete faith in the wisdom of the people of East Cheam. Today will be the turning point in the destiny of this borough. What is to be, will be.
Who said that?
I did. Why don't you listen when people are talking? Switch the radio on, Sid. The results should be in by now.
The minister said he would have been to it. Here are the results of the East Cheam by-election. Arnold Biggs, 29,348. Sir Reginald Featherstone Hoare, 28,903. Anthony Hancock, 1.
I demand a recount. This is ridiculous.
Well, at least you got one.
But that was me. Didn't you two even vote for me?
No, I voted for the gentleman with the moustache.
Sid?
I voted for him as well.
Why?
He bought me half a pint of beer.
Stabbed in the back for sevenpence halfpenny. Oh, well, if at first you don't succeed, try again. Rimsky-Korsakov.
Still, the election wasn't a complete waste of time. You have got something out of it.
What?
Well, the local independent party have sent you 50 packets of cornflakes as a consolation for losing.
Oh, how nice of them. Well, see, every cloud may have a silver lining. I think I'll have some now. Pass me the top of the milk. Lovely. Delicious.
Quick, he's choking. Thump him on the back.
Well, we've developed your X-ray, Mr. Hancock, and you definitely did swallow something.
What was it, Doctor?
It appears to be a little plastic guardsman.
Can you get it out?
No, I'm afraid he's wedged. I'm terribly sorry, old chap.
Doctor, you can tell me. I can take it. I don't want you to lie to me. I want you to give it to me straight.
What instrument was he playing?
He was a trumpet player.
Stone me, isn't it marvelous?
Thank you.